Welcome back. Let us have a look at the correlated sampling technique, which is one of the variance reduction methods. The application of the correlated sampling technique is limited to specific problems in which we need to calculate the difference between two very similar systems. So let's denote the first system as g1. So g1 is a function that describes the first system, and the second system is described by the g2 function. So because they are a little bit different, they also have different results. So the result y1 describes the first system, the result y2 describes the outcome of the second system. So we want to calculate the difference. That very often happens when we want to know the effect of some small change in the system to the result. So for instance, you want to calculate the multiplication factor of the system when you change slightly the geometry. So for instance, you change the density of the coolant a little bit, and you want to know whether the multiplication factor increases or decreases. Now, the problem is that when this change to the geometry in the system is very small, then the change in the result, so for instance in the multiplication factor, is also very small. The change is small. And it may be very challenging to calculate these small changes in the result because of the presence of the random noise. So you may run a Monte Carlo simulation for the first system, so you will obtain the result as the mean value of y1 plus minus the standard deviation of the mean value. And similarly, the second system you can also simulate by the Monte Carlo method, so you will obtain the result in the form of the mean value of the second y plus minus the standard deviation of the mean value of y2. Now we could estimate the difference between these two systems by subtracting the mean value of y1 and the mean value of y2. However, this difference may be smaller than the standard deviation for the mean value of y1 or the standard deviation of the mean value of y2. So in that case, the result, the difference that you could calculate, would not be very accurate. It would contain very large errors. So if you wanted to obtain a very good estimate of the difference of these two mean values, then you would have to make sure that the standard deviation that you calculate for each mean value would be sufficiently small. It would have to be much, much smaller than the difference of these two mean values. So that's a problem. It could take very, very long computing time to reduce the standard deviation to such a level. So for these kind of problems, the correlated sampling technique is extremely efficient. And the idea of the correlated sampling technique is to calculate the difference directly during the Monte Carlo simulation. So we simulate the both system at the same time, and we use the same random number for evaluation of the both system. So during the simulation, we sample the x value, the input random variable, from its probability density function, and each value that we generate we will input to the G1 function as well as to the G2 function, and we subtract the Y values that we obtain from both systems. Now you may remember that we were doing very similar thing when we were discussing the control variate method. So in case of the control variate method, we also were calculating difference between the original system and the control variate, and we were sampling the differences. So when we want to calculate the variance of this difference, we can actually use the results that we already obtained in the previous mini lesson. If you go back, you will find out that we actually tried to calculate the variance of the difference of two random variables. So we can directly take that result and put it here. So the variance of the difference of two systems, that is this z random variable, is the combination of three terms: the variance of the first system, the variance of the second system, and these two are combined with the positive signs, and then we have a term with a negative sign, which is the covariance of the two systems. Now if we calculated this difference of two systems by the standard Monte Carlo method, that means if we evaluated the first system at first, and then we calculated the result for the second system and subtracted these values, then the variance of this result would be the combination of the variance of the random variable y1 and the variance of the random variable y2. There wouldn't be this third term. So as you can see, the correlated sampling technique can reduce the variance considerably, assuming that the covariance of y1 and y2 is sufficiently large. So if there is no correlation between these two systems, well then this covariance term would be zero, and you would obtain the same variance as in the standard Monte Carlo approach. However, that typically doesn't happen when we use the correlated sampling technique. We always apply to the case when we are making very small change in the system and we want to calculate the change in the result. So in that case, the both systems are very similar, that means they are correlated, and this covariance term is very large, and it can reduce the variance of the difference of these two systems a lot. And that is all. Have a nice day.